You use pricing schemes to define advanced pricing models for rate plan templates. In this video, we'll take you through a brief tour of the pricing configuration to explain how the pricing scheme is built. The tour starts with the field catalog, which contains the fields that are used to define lookup tables and input properties of price element specifications. The catalog already contains the predefined fields that you need to set the prices of your subscription products. These are product code, market ID, rate element, and rate sub-element. Other relevant fields are those used to calculate discounts and prices. Now we'll continue with the lookup tables. In a lookup table, you define the mapping between a set of input fields, which come from the field catalog, and an output field, for example, a price condition. This allows you to determine the relevant price condition, such as price or discount, for the input fields. You later set the value of the price condition in the lookup table data. Now let's see how you use the lookup tables to define your price element specifications. A price element specification holds the algorithm for calculating an individual price element. You define the algorithm in the pricing tree. Here you see an example algorithm for a recurring price. The formula indicates how the price condition is determined. The price condition is then used to calculate the amount for the price element. This tour ends with the pricing scheme, with which you specify the rules for combining and aggregating price element specifications to generate the price elements for each charge in a rate plan template. We recommend that you use the initial pricing scheme as an example to create your own pricing schemes. It's a predefined scheme that contains price element specifications for discounts and for one-time, recurring, and usage-based charges. This concludes our overview of the pricing configuration. Thank you for watching.